know, today our team is going to talk about like why it's important to know your strengths and weakness. So this slide is divided into three parts. So first, I'm going to talk about the strengths and weakness for the job interviews. So raise your hand if you guys have ever asked to talk about the strengths and weakness during the job interviews. Yeah, so like pretty much everybody. And this is like a common question that comes on like every single job interviews. And I'm going to talk just briefly why like this kind of questions are on the job interviews. Just talking about the strength, first is like the companies are looking for the candidates who can add value to the company and just for the team. This is for like the skill set. Like for example, if like one candidate is very proficient in like Excel, like modeling, visualizing, like PowerPoint, so that when the candidate joins the firm, they can just immediately make an output from day one. And second is like a candidate who has like a great fit to the company's culture. This is more of like a personal character, so it's very important to do the company's research and try to figure out if your personal characteristics aligns with the company's culture. So do the research. And second is like weakness on your job interviews. Just like never tell that you don't have a weakness, sis. And I know you guys are very smart enough to know like these questions. They're actually very interested on your stories, like such as like how you ended up getting like this and this weakness, and how you put your effort to overcome this kind of weakness. They're trying to see the process of like how you overcome the weaknesses. So I hope you guys are very aware of like these kind of information.
Cool. Yeah. So knowing your strengths and weaknesses is essential for just personal decision making. So I mean, basically, just going throughout life, making decisions all the time. Most of them are instantaneous, easy, don't require much thought, but many do require careful reflection on kind of the issues at hand. And if you're familiar with your strengths and weaknesses, these become a lot easier because you're familiar with what you're good at, what you're not. So you won't spend as much time deliberating and wasting time trying to figure out if you're going to be able to solve a problem or capitalize on an opportunity, because you already know, yeah, I can deal with that, or maybe I can't, but that's something I need to work on because I know my weaknesses. So just being familiar with those, you're already halfway there. So you know, you're just becoming more familiar with yourself, and then other things come easier after that.
Yeah, so going off of that, one of your biggest decisions is choosing a career path. All of us sophomores, juniors,